Good morning, students of Standard 8. Today in the subject Social Studies, we are going to do the Components of Business Studies, Chapter 1, Part 4. In the previous three videos, you have understood what business is, what are economic activities, you have learnt about the terms consumer, consumption, production, and you have seen many more things in it, right? We are now going to focus on our attention on the important stages of economic development in this video. Are you there with me? Yes. The important stages of economic evolution. Man has been living in one way right in the beginning. If you have studied in history about the old stone age, the new stone age, etc., you will understand that we have come a very, very, very long way. We have progressed to such an extent today that we can sit in one place and understand what's happening all over the world. We can witness it, we can see it. We know, hear about it is true. We can even see things happening. We can be a part of many virtual activities also. So all this evolution has taken place and it has played a major role in business also. That's what we are going to see about now. The first one is the hunting and fishing stage. You know that man in the earliest of civilizations, how he lived, how he clothed himself, how from a quadruped he became a biped. He used to walk on his fours. Then he realized that he is a man and he has got a spine, he can stand straight. So he grew from that stage to what he is today. So what was his lifestyle then? What was his food? What was his requirement of clothing and shelter? All this we will be doing very briefly, just to show you the change that has taken place from this phase of life to what man is today. So initially, in the earliest of human civilization, man was a wanderer. A wanderer is a person who moves in from place to place, aimlessly though, in search of food. At this time, it was in search of food. Because it was the earliest of human civilization, all he needed was food, clothing and shelter. And for food, he was satisfied by walking from place to place and gather whatever he gets in the region there. So what was he eating? He used to hunt animals and that also with stones and, you know, all crude weapons. He did not have anything so good to kill the animals also. He went fishing and he gathered fruits, nuts and roots of trees. So this is how he filled his stomach. He satiated his hunger. How did he clothe himself? What do you think he wore? Very good. He wore the skins of animals or he plucked the leaves of trees and he covered his body mainly to protect himself from the sun, the wind and the rain. Is that clear? All right. What was his shelter then? He lived in the hollows of trees. Who lives in the hollows of trees? You can see animals living normally, right? So here he lived in the hollows of trees. You can see the owls in the hollows of trees. This is the place man occupied. Or he lived in the caves, wherever he found an empty cave in the region. No economic activity. There was absolutely no economic activity. The next stage was the pastoral stage. Pastoral comes from the word pasture. What is a pasture? Grassland. What do you get an idea from? What do you think he was doing, man, at that time? Yes, he had sheep, goats. Cows came much later. He started domestication of animals. That is, he started having goats and sheep as his pets. He looked after them, took care of them. Obviously, when he takes care of them, what will he go in search of? What will he go in search of? Grass for these animals. So, yes, he started looking out for pastures, grasslands, so that his sheep and goat could graze. What was his food then? From the animals, whatever he got from sheep and goat. What will he get from sheep and goat? Anyone? Milk, very good. Fur for his clothing, wonderful. Yes. Meat, yes. So he grew a little more now. He started eating meat. That time also he was hunting. So here he started domesticating these animals, taking care of them and had his food from them. Clothing, what did he wear? Skins of animals. And here you can add even the fur that he may be taking out from the sheep. He might be using it. Yes. Shelter. Did he have a shelter? No. He did not stay in a fixed place. Yes, whenever he stayed in a fixed place, he tried to sleep maybe in some grassland areas are all open only. So he had to sleep along with these animals. So he just tried to see if he could find a cave or something nearby or a tree where he could rest. But basically grasslands are open areas. So he kept on moving from place to place in search of grasslands. No economic activity in this time also. Now we go to the third stage, and that is the agricultural stage. What does this suggest? Agriculture means growing crops. Man now became slightly better. He started understanding that he could grow some crops and make a living out of it also. So what did he do then? He started learning the art of growing crops. Why is it called an art? How to dig, how much to dig, how to sow the seeds, when to water, is the water too much, too less, what type of crop will grow in which soil. All this knowledge he started gathering slowly, and he became successful in growing crops for his own needs. He grew something which he could eat. It could be some vegetables, it could be some fruits, whatever he could grow within his capacity so that he can take care of himself. And then clothing, he used the plant material for clothes. Not a big change over there. So this was something else that had happened. And shelter, now he decided he cannot keep loitering around the town. He has to have a fixed place of stay because his agricultural plots or the village area or the place where he started growing the crops needed attention, and this can be done only and only if he is close by. So he started making some kind of shelter for himself with some leaves maybe or some mud that was around. So some small shelter he made for himself, and he didn't stay alone. He was fixed in a fixed place in groups. He had started building friends, yes. He had started getting more and more social, yes. Villages and communities came into existence. So when you have more people, you need more sort of houses. So there were about 10-15 houses started developing there. You know, then somebody said, see, I know how to sow the seed. Someone said, I know how to plow the land. So slowly the division of labor also began. It was not one person focusing on one thing. Many people gathered together, decided to start things together, and decided to pitch in their abilities together. As a result, commercial activities started. That is, they grew different things. Many other kinds of activities also began. Commerce entered. Commercial activities started. Then came the next stage, and that is called the handicraft stage. Handicrafts, you must have seen many handicrafts emporium. What does it mean? People who are skilled in art and craft. Those who can make beautiful statues, they can do so many things. Some of them can, you know, are very good at craft work, some with artwork. All this developed. How? Because the many people started living together. And in the previous one itself, you saw division of labor began. So somebody said, see, I'm not good in all this growing and all, you know, but I can help you with the tools you need for the agriculture. You need a spade, no? I know how to do that. I know how to make that. So somebody said, see, I'm not good with making tools, but I can do some other activity. So when this started, you know, labor also started getting divided. People started doing different things in order to earn a living and share their whatever they made with each other. So here they wanted some tools or implements. In the handicraft stage, they wanted tools or implements. So what did they do? Food, what did they have? Barter system of exchange started. They exchanged food crops with craftsmen who produced goods in their houses and gave it to agriculturists. So now what happened was these craftsmen are skilled people in a specialized job like sculpture, okay, making statues from a rock. They make a statue, or they, you know, they build the roofs, the pillars, all those things, specialized work that they do. So these craftsmen, they stayed at home and they made the goods, whatever was required. And what did these agriculturists do? Those who went to the farm, plowed the land, tilled, sowed the seeds, grew the crops. What they did was they got together with these craftsmen. They bought some tools from them. Bought with through what? They did not have any money at that time. So they took the tools and they gave a certain portion of the crops that they grow so that they could eat food and these people could use the tools to grow better crops. That kind of an understanding developed, and that was called the barter system of exchange. And they wanted houses, so now they started making tools and building houses. Building houses means what? You think they made these kind of houses? No, it would have been mud and clay. Whatever is available in the vicinity, they tried to use that and make their own houses. Who made the houses? These craftsmen. Craftsmen could have been carpenters, they could be blacksmiths, they could be builders. Did you understand? So the specialized job which they knew, which they could practice. All right. So professional craftsmen, blacksmiths, weavers and builders came up. Weavers are those who make beautiful saris and dhotis and all. They weave it into cloth. Next, we move on to the barter system stage. Division of labor enabled quick production of goods. The goods produced were directly exchanged. That is the meaning of it. The direct exchange of goods for goods and other things is called the barter system of exchange. This was the fourth stage. Is that clear, children? All right. To summarize, the different stages in evolution, the hunting stage, pastoral stage, agricultural stage, handicraft stage, barter stage. And then we move on to some questions. Questions here. Explain the barter system of exchange. What was the food, clothing and shelter in the hunting and pastoral stage? Write about the changes seen in the handicraft stage. Write a short note on the agricultural stage. It is the, T-H-E, not H-E. Name some craftsmen. I'm sure you have understood, children. Thank you.